Good day, everybody. It is AirPirateCid, and welcome back to more Let's Play Parasite 2. In the last episode, completely had a brain fart. If you didn't watch the last episode, well, go watch it. That way you'll know what I did. End of this episode, we're going to continue on with what I was doing. And if you didn't watch the last episode, well, there you go. You will never know what I'm doing now. Ha 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 ha. And yes, if you check this plant right here, you can pick up the other lipstick that I was mentioning earlier in this playthrough. Or in this Let's Play, rather. Let's see here. We're just gonna go on ahead and... Yeah, I need to free up some inventory space, so I'm gonna go on ahead and waste a ringer solution. Screw it. And then after that, well, that's all I really want to waste. I could go on ahead and just throw these two away, because I'm not going to be using them for the rest of this game, so... I'm gonna go on ahead and just discard them. Screw it. I have no further use for them. As cool as they were, they have outlived their use. There we go. I had to stand on top of it just to open it. Why couldn't I have just been right next to it to open it? There's a hole in the bottom of the sea. There's a hole in the bottom of the ground. Yeah, I know those aren't the lyrics, but hey, whatever. Funny how I went from the bottom of the sea to the bottom of the ground. Either way, we're going down the hole! Oh yes, this is going to be quite the fun experience, viewers. Come on. Whenever you kill enough of these things, we are going to get into an optional boss fight. See that gigantic thing swimming out there? Yeah, that's our target. Hey, whoa, no, man. Whoa, I thought you were about to shoot me. Hello. Yep, now I'm gonna dodge that. Come on. I wanna watch you explode. There we go! Ha 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 ha! Boom, headshot. And here we go. It is time for optional boss time. Hello, ugly. You are pretty large. There we go. Holy crap, that really hurt. Just continue hitting you with fire. That's all it takes to take down this boss, is just hitting it with fire repeatedly. You know what? I kind of want to see you blow up, so I think I very well may try that. So let's just dodge all that. Oh, grenade to the face, but yet you did not blow up. So let's try that again. You know, actually, if you bought the pike attachment for your rifle, or for the, whatever weapon I'm using right now, the one that uses a lot of attachments. If you actually bought the, flamethrower attachment for it, then this fight will be incredibly easy right now. And there we go, he didn't blow up, though. But he kind of vanished for a half second, like he was going to. But anywhom, if you actually got the pike attachment for the, assault rifle, then this boss fight is incredibly easy. You just hold the R2 button and just set his ass on fire! And let's just go on ahead and... Actually, I want to just go on ahead and just use those, actually, so... Yeah. Okay, well, there we go. I just wasted a protein capsule. And oh my goodness, wow, look at that pool of blood right there. It's a floating melted creature's... floating melted creature remains. There's a strong lemony smell. Why would it smell like lemons? Are you trying to tell me that Eelektrik smells like lemons in Pokemon? I don't know. Why am I still referencing Pokemon? Why is God with 2Ds pissed with that? Why is there something shiny floating? Let's pick it up. It's a question mark crystal. Oh my goodness, it is the crystal skull. Indiana Jones. Well, whatever. It's a skull-shaped South American crystal. Attach this and see what happens. I'm not sure exactly what happens if you use it, but I'm pretty sure it has something or another to do with the fact that you'll end up invoking some kind of a particular spell. And in this case, I think that it would be water. I do believe. Not 200% positive as to what it is, but either way, we're not going to use it. We're just going to move it, because if you move it, it actually increases your bullet damage by 20%. No, actually, I want to kind of exchange that for that. And after that, just exchange that for my, where is it? Ofuda. Reason being is because I want all those attachments to be up there, so everything's easier to find. And there we have it. Yay! Now that we have the crystal skull, we have increased bullet damage. And we've also got the Ofuda, which increases magic damage. So everything's going pretty well right now. And also, we're still pretty close to the end of the game. I'm predicting maybe another 5 to 10 videos. Most likely, that should be the end of this LP. Now, surprisingly, my Parasite Eve only took 30 videos, which was actually a good thing, because I wanted to start it on January the 1st and end it on the 30th. And it went, no, December the 1st and ended on the 31st or something. No, 30th. Maybe 31st. I don't know. But either way, Parasite Eve 1 was only 30 videos, and this one's probably going to be closer to 40. So in the end, this one is the longer game. By a long shot, actually. Because I think the fastest I've ever beaten this game is like in maybe 5 to 6 hours, and then after that, the fastest I've beaten Parasite Eve 1 is 2.5 to 3 hours. And as for the third birthday, I know that I own it, but I have not yet played it yet. Then again, I've only owned it for the past 3-4 days. Yeah, I've owned it for about 4 days now. But I still have not yet played it. Why? Because I'm focusing on this game first. And after I beat this one, then chances are I'll go on ahead and move on to it. I don't even know where I'm going with this conversation anymore. But I'm thirsty, so hold on a second while I take a drink of soda. There we go, just skip that. Don't need to watch that cutscene all over again. It's basically the same cutscene, only in reverse, so instead of the bridge going from left to right, it just goes from right to left. This place just seriously has that feel of Jurassic Park, I swear. It just does. It's really, really, really crazy like that. Let's see, I have over 3,000 points. That costs 4,000. It only costs 3,000. That's pretty good, in my opinion, but I don't want that one. Let's see, that's 5,000. Bonus MP, 4. No, I never paid attention to that. You get 1 bonus MP for that. You get 1 for that. You get 4 for that. You get 4 for that. You get 2 for that. And you get 2 for that. Interesting. I never paid attention to that before. Now, if you're wondering where I'm seeing the bonus MP, it's right below experience cost, and I've never paid attention to the bonus MP before. Screw it. I'm just gonna wait until I get 5,000 for Inferno level 3. Just because that's gonna be the most powerful spell, and I have not yet been using antibody or energy shot as of late. Did I just say as of late instead of lately? Oh, style of old talking. You are treasured in my mind. Now then, viewers, are we all ready to continue on with the story and fight not one boss fight in one video, but 2 boss fights in one video? It's like going to Blockbuster back whenever you were a kid and getting 2 games for the price of 1 for the weekend. Even though I never did that, really, as a kid, I think I did it maybe once or twice, and the one game that I remember renting as a child, for the most part, was Kirby 64, and I ended up beating that game, like, in less than 3 hours. I didn't beat it 100%, I think I may have beaten it about 80 or 90, but still. Holy crap, you're glitching through my screen. Why are you doing that? Don't glitch through my screen like that. You know what? Blow up! Okay, well, that did not blow you up. No, I don't think I want to waste another grenade in trying to get you to blow up. Go, there you are. Don't hide from me. There we go. That's right, eat a grenade in the face. And then after that, next grenade should blow you up to smithereens! Hardy-hoo-hoo. Wait. I've just come to the realization that I have not at all used my unique laughter in such a long time. And I really need to incorporate that more into my LPs, is la-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha. Oh, la ha 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 ha. Yeah, small island lies not far away. It's too far to jump, though. know, even if you were to jump over there, how would you get back? You would have to swim and get all wet. I sense a skinny-dipping cutscene in the fourth Parasite Eve if it ever comes out. They've been doing the shower scenes for the last two games now, but if they ever come out with a fourth Parasite Eve, I'm pretty sure they're just gonna go all the way and just go skinny-dipping. That's right, we want to target you. Eat pyrokinesis, you fat bastard! Oh, oh goodness, oh my goodness. Whoa, no, stop. There we go. Holy crap, these things are... Ah, ha, 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 look at that. You can actually end up shooting those with a grenade or some kind of explosive, and they will fall flat on their ass. And whenever they do that, well, they're incredibly vulnerable to attacks. But, eh, didn't feel like wasting a grenade on that one. There we go, 12 HP and 12 MP bonus, and I finally have over 20,000 BP! As in the gas company? No. No. Woo! Alright, here we go. It's time to fight the second ANMC. But before I do that, if you walk back here, I think that you can actually end up finding some ammo if you happen to have a handgun. A wooden box. What's inside? It's full of ammunition! Why would they have a box of ammunition here? I don't know, but you could get infinite hydra right there if you want it, or even if you need it. But if you're like me and if you've been sticking with the assault rifle for the vast majority of the game, well, you're pretty well set to go on that. Hello, ugly! Wow, look how gigantic that thing is! It's so big! Its head is bigger than Jay Leno's chin! That's pretty big. Okay, there we go, and I'm just gonna go on ahead and target these first. Just because. See, if you shoot it while it's still plugged up to the electricity, it'll just end up recovering its health anyways. So there's really no point in doing that. And therefore I'm not gonna do it again. But there we go. There goes that. And time to take out the rest of the cameras just for the extra experience. Aha! Alright, you ugly bastard. It's time for you to meet lead. Eat it! Eat it! It's... Eat some! Get some! Grenade! Oh, what? You actually lift the grenade? Okay, fine. Hasta la vista, baby! Boosh! Now, the only reason why I said hasta la vista, baby, is because I randomly thought of the Terminator theme in my head. The barrier disappeared, but I can still feel something emanating from far below. I think that might mean that you need to go use the toilet, Aya. You might need to go use the toilet. Bonus items! Ooh! We're gonna go on ahead and use... Oh, wait, we can't even use that because we are already at full MP and everything like... Excuse me. We're already at full MP and HP, so that's always good. Oh, how it's so tempting to replace something... Well, actually, I'm just gonna exchange that for some ringer solution. I probably should have used a belt pouch for this piece of armor, but I didn't. And I don't really have any regrets towards that. All I know is that once again, enemies have ended up respawning here. And actually, I know where the enemies are in the power plant. They're on the other side. So, let's go on ahead and exit out of here. No, I already know I'm 14 and a half minutes into this recording, but it sure as hell does not feel like it's been 14 and a half minutes. It only feels like it's been like 5. So I guess that time flies if you're having fun, and in this case, I'm having a lot of fun. Yeah, I'm just gonna go on ahead and end this video right here. So thank you all for watching Let's Play Parasite Eve 2! I will see you all in the next episode! Yay!